January 10th, 2015. It is the special Yama Dinner edition of The Daily Star with Jon Stewart. Jon couldn't be here tonight, so tonight's guest host is Eric Fremming.
Good evening, and welcome to this special edition of The Daily Show. Jon Stewart couldn't be here tonight. Turns out he didn't have enough air journal credit, so they asked me to fill in last minute. Tonight, we're going to take you into the hallways of Yavne Academy to give you an inside glimpse of what your kids do every day at school. We want to know how they really feel about going to Yavne Academy. The first question we asked, what do you like about Yavne? What are the good things about Yavne Academy?
Studying Torah.
Excellent. What else?
Some of the teachers, they're really nice. They make class fun.
Mrs. Knudsen, the music teacher, she's really nice. She has a choir.
Oh, we have two other teachers from Israel also. Yavne has a great program. We get probably the best teachers.
How's the Wi-Fi here?
It's really good.
Why is the new building better than the old building?
Because it's more modern.
It's not a jail. I like everything about it.
What do you think about the lunch here at Yavne? What's your favorite meal?
Me? I love meat day.
What do you do with the computers?
What do we press again?
Art.
What's your favorite thing at Yavne?
Art.
Art. Good.
Different things every time, like hamburgers, hot dogs.
I love to go there.
Sure, they're happy now, but what concerns do they have about their future? Where do they see themselves professionally in a few years? What do you want to be when you grow up?
Actually, a doctor and a construction worker.
It's important to get a good education.
Because if I don't get a good education, I won't be able to be the first woman president of the United States.
I'm Princess One, and I'm the queen, so I'm in charge of every person in the whole world. And I also have servants.
So we know you're interested in a career in politics. What do you want to do when you grow up?
Military.
First, I want to be a five-star general, which my teacher tells every day.
No, I don't think you get to be the five-star general first.
No. And then I'm going to be a Secret Service person for the president.
Yeah, Sam, you'll work for me someday.
No, if you want to get that job, you have to have good education. So I'm proud that Yavne gives the most money.
You sound so sophisticated. So,
I want to be a special effects person.
I
just want to make stuff blow up.
Fire it all.
They're going to need a good educational foundation to accomplish all that, including a good college education. What you may not know is that they already know where they want to go. So where do you guys want to go to college?
I want to go to either Penn, Columbia, something like that.
All good schools?
Yeah.
My dream would be to go to Harvard Law, but that's not that realistic, so maybe Princeton Law.
I want to go to Columbia and I want to take on my family business.
Okay.
Rutgers and then become a doctor.
I want to turn and become a teacher.
Oh, of course.
Graduate Duke and go to the MBA.
No one ever accused a Yavne student of not aiming high enough. Speaking of the NBA, the kids are not the only ones with high aspirations. Who do you think would win on one-on-one? LeBron James or Rabbi Knapp?
Rabbi Knapp! Rabbi Knapp! Okay. Rabbi Knapp! Rabbi Knapp!
So there's an interesting matchup. Rabbi Knapp versus LeBron. Who was a better basketball player? LeBron James or Rabbi Knapp?
LeBron James.
No. Rabbi Penn would win.
Rabbi Penn would win. Any comment on the rumor that you're going to take LeBron on one-on-one?
Yes. Well, plenty of comments on that.
Any trash talk you want to give LeBron?
Yeah, tell LeBron to bring it, baby. I'm ready to go. Ready to roll.
Give me that title.
Okay, my man. Rabbi Knapp, LeBron just called. He said as soon as Yavne's new gymnasium is ready, it's on. Turns out, Rabbi Knapp is not Yavne's only secret weapon when it comes to basketball. How hard our administrators work to give our kids the best experience money can buy. But what's our kids' understanding of what it takes to put together a crack administrative team about the dollars and cents, nuts and bolts issues that our administrators and our lay leadership have to deal with day in and day out to deliver a superior product? To find out, we went deep undercover into the Yavne classroom to see what our kids really think.
Oh my God, kids, who's this?
Hi, mites! Is this Yavne Academy? Yes. Who runs this place? Who's in charge here?
Rabbi Knapp.
Rabbi Knapp? I don't know who that is. What does he look like?
Yes, right here.
Just walks around.
And that's his job? Who's the principal?
Rabbi Knapp.
Rabbi, you know, I've heard a lot about him.
Actually, there's another principal.
Rabbi Penn.
So.
Who's in charge of Yavne Camp?
We have no idea.
Okay, fair enough.
Mrs. Rubin, she helps a lot.
Uh-huh. Joel Kirshner, do you know him?
No.
Never heard of him?
No.
Never saw him?
My dad did.
Do you know Officer Sal?
Yes.
He's my favorite.
Yes.
What's his job?
To make sure that people don't get hurt.
Uh-huh. Who's in charge of everybody at Yavne? Yes.
Rabbi Knapp.
Rabbi Knapp. Okay.
No, Rabbi Penn.
And Rabbi Penn.
Rabbi Penn is the principal.
Do you know Joel Kirshner?
No.
No. Is it free to come here to Yavne Academy?
Yes.
It doesn't cost anything at all?
No.
Oh, so this is a good deal. How much does it cost?
$2.
Is that $2?
$100.
I'm looking for a friend of mine. His name is Joel Kirshner. Do you know him? Do you know Joel Kirshner? How much do you think?
$200.
$50,000 per person, counting lunch.
Yes.
That's like the cost of like 10 Ferraris.
So does it cost a lot to go to Yavne?
I think so.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because we asked the kindergarten kids, and they gave us pretty good answers. They said it was $200. Okay.
$5 million.
Does it cost a lot of money to go to Yavne?
No.
Yes.
No, it doesn't. Costs zero.
Zero, it's free. So let me see if I got this right. Based on our undercover intelligence, it takes anywhere from $0 to $50 million to send your child to Yavne for a year. Sounds about right. But the real question is it worth it? Do your kids appreciate the education that through your hard work, Yavne provides? Would you recommend the school to someone else?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll probably send them to Yavne.
Would you send your children to Yavne Academy?
If I stayed in Jersey, yeah.
When you have kids of your own, would you send them to Yavne Academy?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's a good place to start your life. It's very helpful.
In fact, it turns out our kids love Yavne so much, they don't want to leave. If Yavne announced that they were going to open their own Yavne High School, who here would go? Why would you want to stay in the same school that you've been at for 10 years already?
Because it's a fun environment. We just love Yamna in general.
There we go.
Yamna High School. Yamna High School.
Thank you, Mom and Dad. I love my school.
Thank you for sending me to Yamna.
Thanks, Mom and Dad, for sending us to Yamna.
Yamna rocks!
Well, that about wraps it up for tonight. Thanks for watching. Make sure to tune in tomorrow night when our guests include Officer Sal, Pam Scheiniger, and, wait for it, Judy Moldovan. Good night.